the News 8 Storm Team forecast with Chief Meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
Well, if you are out and about driving tonight or even into tomorrow morning, the roads are a little damp, and some of the side roads, some of the blacktop may be a little slippery because temperatures have really gotten colder in the last couple of hours, down to 22 officially right now. Winds are calm. You have calm winds. We had a little bit of clearing in some spots, or even in the teens. So for the overnight hours, I do think we'll see some more clearing, but a brisk cold night. Could be a few flurries left over in the next few hours. I'll show you those coming up. The disturbance we thought would maybe bring a few snow showers is really starting to die out. We'll be in the teens and 20s, and the winds are going to pick up. So tomorrow morning, yeah, you'll have those wind chills in the maybe upper single digits, certainly the teens. Blustery cold morning, just a few clouds around, and mainly sunny afternoon. Blustery and cold with wind chills in the teens for tomorrow, only 32 to 36. That's the last one, though. I think temperatures are going up after that. 11 right now in Sealands Grove. Temperatures all over. They've been bouncing up and down, depending if you get some clearing and then some clouds come in. Carlisle, 19. So is York, 23 in E-Town, though. But, yeah, some teens out there at this hour. Now, nothing showing up on the radar right around us. But you see up around State College, there have been a few flurries. There was a disturbance. It's right in here. Actually, the one from this morning is now moving up through Boston and Maine, but it's moving away pretty quickly. And we are getting that little bit of drying in between the two weather systems. But here's the next one that's moving on through now. And again, I don't think it really does much more than just kick up the winds as we go through the next couple of hours. But there it is, right through Cincinnati up toward Cleveland. And again, that's coming through. We have a little break between it. This one is the one that came through for this morning. And then behind it, high pressure builds in. Looks like a couple of decent days, and we should start warming up a bit. So let's time it out for you. Again, the clouds start to clear a little bit. I think it's going to be colder than the predictor things. And then as we go through the day, most of the clouds lift off to our north. Low to mid-30s. Again, it's chillier than it should be, but not all that bad. The winds make it feel a little colder than it really is for tomorrow afternoon. We see a few more clouds as we go into Thursday, but look at the numbers. Yeah, getting back into the 40s. Well, I don't think we're going to stop there either. We'll be back up, perhaps even warmer as we go into the rest of the 7-day forecast. But a blustery, cold day tomorrow. Again, overnight we'll be in the teens near 20 degrees. Then a brisk, cold morning. But the afternoon, again, sunshine, but those winds make it feel like it's in the teens. Then the 40 on Thursday. Then it looks like we could get some showers in here on Friday. But look at the numbers, 48 degrees. Chance of some more showers over the weekend. I don't think it's a washout. Better bet of the 2 days would probably be Sunday for some rain, but look at the numbers up near 60 degrees. Then it gets a little bit colder. Like I said earlier, last weekend we had snow. Christmas shoppers couldn't get out and do what they needed to do. Well, winter arrives on Saturday, but it won't feel like it. Could sure be the first time we get 60 in a month.
Good. This is the first time I haven't shoveled my way out of my driveway, sidewalks, or anything, because I'm thinking they'll just melt.